Today is our annual meeting at the 10 a.m. service, actually at the very end of the service. I hope you all come. We're going to have lunch after. It'll be fun. It's not generally my practice to preach on this Sunday. I usually just give my annual meeting report. But today, I'm going to just give you a few thoughts that are on my mind this morning. So this isn't my regular full-blown sermon, just some thoughts on my mind. So the first thing that I've been mulling over this week is the reading from Micah, particularly the threefold requirement of God to do justice, love kindness, and walk humbly with God. Our relationship with God is number one. Placing God at the center of our lives is our priority. What that means for each of us is going to be different, but the main thing is that we make our relationship with God primary in our lives. Walking humbly with our God means knowing that God is God and that we are not. Remembering our humanity and the fact that all that we have, all that we are, comes from God, helps with that humble part of walking with God. And truly, if your relationship with God is primary, humility is going to happen as a result. And with a relationship established with God, a relationship where we know God's love and learn more and more day by day how to love God more fully, doing justice and loving kindness, as the prophet says, or loving mercy, as some translations say, will happen as a result. Now, I'm not saying it's an easy thing to do or that we'll be able to do it at all. But in the depths of our hearts, we will know what justice is. We will know what mercy is in any given situation. Choosing to act on that is something different entirely. We get conflicting messages from the world around us. We are taught to fear, to defend, to do harm, to protect ourselves. That's the world that we live in. And unfortunately, those messages come into our lives way more often than the messages of love. We see fear around us so much more often than we see the love of God around us. But what God requires of us is not fear or defense or protecting ourselves and doing harm to others. What God requires of us is simple: do justice, love mercy, walk humbly with God. So we return to our relationship with God as primary. And then we look again at what it means to do justice, to love mercy and kindness. This is what it means to practice our faith. It's a constant prayer, it's a constant practice, it's a constant work to grapple with that love of God, walking humbly with God as primary, and then understanding what doing justice and loving mercy looks like. The second thing on my mind is the Beatitudes, our gospel reading. It is so well known, and we hear it often enough, that maybe it's lost its punch. But it is a profound part of Jesus' teaching. This is the beginning of Jesus' Sermon on the Mount. Profound because it confounds the values of the world. It cuts straight to the heart and shows us very clearly that God is always looking out for what Jesus called the least of these. The least of these are those without power in our world. The least of these are the poor. The least of these are those who grieve and mourn and suffer in any kind of emotional, spiritual way. The least of these are those who live on the edges of our society, not in the center. And perhaps most importantly for today, the least of these are refugees. These are blessed by God. To know that no matter what it is that you struggle with, you will be blessed in your struggle. And that the justice of God will set things right. That is a powerful thing. I'm also thinking about God's justice. This is a different kind of justice than what our minds come up with. It is a justice that makes things that are unequal equal again. This justice shows up in the Bible over and over and over. It is all over the word from the prophets. It shows up in the Beatitudes. It shows up in a way maybe most familiar to us as Episcopalians, in the Magnificat, Mary's song, when she says, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior, for he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever." And finally, what's on my mind is what is in the news right now, the refugees who seek asylum in our country and are being turned away. Pope Francis spoke out very clearly about this. And religious leaders all over our country, from so many different denominations and from so many different political persuasions, are speaking out against this. Now, every issue is political, and that's just life. But I am not looking at this from a political perspective. I'm considering this from the perspective of being a priest and a pastor, and most fundamentally, a Christian. Our imperative to do justice and love kindness and mercy, and to walk humbly with God, can be interpreted in many different ways. However, the Bible is pretty clear about welcoming the stranger and the foreigner. It's clear about extending hospitality. It's clear about loving everyone, about striving for justice and peace among all people, and respecting the dignity of every human being. I would also add, that just comes to mind now that I'm standing before you, how important the message of welcome and hospitality is for our church here at Epiphany, but also for the Episcopal Church. And that's what we say. The Episcopal Church welcomes you. We say that no matter where you are in your journey of faith, you are welcome here. Well, that welcome goes for everyone. That welcome is the welcome of Christ. It is what it means to be a Christian. So I go back to Micah over and over about walking humbly with God. And when I place that imperative as primary in my life, I find no reason to turn others away. When I place loving God as my primary work in the world, I cannot look at someone who is suffering in any way and not see the suffering of God in that person's face. I cannot see the refugees fleeing for their lives and not see them as beloved of God and blessed by God. And for me, as a person with power in this world, just by virtue of where I live, my attempt to humbly walk with God compels me to stand before you with humility and say, loving God means loving the least of these. Loving God means loving these refugees. It means finding a way to help them, not turning them away. Loving God means loving everyone, because God loves everyone. I am praying for all of us to have the grace and the discernment and the strength to do justice, to love kindness and mercy, and to walk humbly with our God. I am praying that when our day comes to stand face to face before God, we can do so with our hearts open and our consciences clear. I am praying that in these complicated times, we may act according to the purposes of God and with God's love as our guide. I hope you will join me.